Hey there guys, Pratish here, back with a brand new video, and in this video we are going to create a simple text editor just inside Python and tkInter. So that is Tkinter even though. So let me open up the project here. This is the main project, which consists of a nice looking screen. Here is the maximize, minimize icon, and you can get all this kind of four settings here. Let me type something like hi, and this is Pratyush, kind of thing like that. So you can just type this thing here, and it's a great editor because we have different functionality here. Like we have the file where you can create a new file, basically let me try it by clicking here, and you can see here we have the new file. Let me type something here and let's save it. So once you click on save, it will pop up a window all right there. So it has been saved as the name Untitled. Now once you click save as, now it will open up this window here where you can just save this thing. Okay, works well. And you can see here that oops, unable to save the file because we have not saved it right. Now we have different thing like quit here, which will basically quit the program. Now we have the edit menu like copy, cut, paste and undo, redo, kind of thing like that. So you can choose this undo to undo everything and redo to redo everything. All right there. And you have the find option also, which will basically find a string. Like I will say H, then okay, and it will find the string all right there. And now we have select all function, which will basically help us to selecting all these things. And we have the background changing options, font color, and we have the fonts here. You can change any of these fonts. These fonts are up your system, so you can change it nearby. We have bold to make this string bold. And we have even though italic, which will make the text italic, and we have to add some date. Then here is thing, and here is the help menu where you can see the credit out right there. So this is the simple editor and it is all about. So let me just create a new file here, and once you see here we have different file options. You can just click on this thing to extract this thing out. So yeah, works well. So let me show you how it works and the code behind the functionality. So let me open up my code editor and let me show you. So here is the first file. So in this file I am basically importing the tkinter. You can do so by pip installing tkinter on your command prompt or terminal. Now let me zoom in so that you can see it clearly. And here we have different functions, like we have the class edit function. This class will basically act as a reference to different kind of thing like definitions, and we have created different functions here which will work together, and then we will bind them together as a whole. So this is a thing. So this I have created a class. If you don't know what is class, what is a function, then I have created another channel of my name, that is Pratyush Mishra. You can check that channel out, where I just show you the basic of Python, where you can just learn some basics about Python. Alright, so now we have the right click function here, which will basically help you to create some pop-up icons. Like we have here copy. So it will basically, what it will do, it will get the text from the selection area and it will copy it. And simply we have the cut and we have the paste. Now this self refers to the text, and this text is a function here which will basically insert to the clipboard. Now this clipboard, you can just copy this from anywhere. And we have the select all function, which will basically select all of the words. We have undo and redo. Now this is the function here. This function comes along with the tkinter, so you don't have to worry about it. What is these things? These are pre-packed with the tkinter. Now here is the text.edit.undo. Now this will underscore undo. So basically this will help you to undo works and redo to redo the works. Well, these are the arguments here. These are optional arguments. And we have the find function here, which will basically find a string in this whole document. So we have like if the target, then it will search for it, otherwise it will not. So this is the basic functionality. And now we have the init file, which will basically help us to know what are the files in our document. So this works perfectly with the OS module also. Now we have created a main here, which will help us to create new commands. Like I have given a command here, like control or command C on your keyboard to just copy the thing. So these are the basic commands. You can do so by going to the accelerator and giving the command to the object. So object edit. Now basically we will bind all of this to the control key. So these are the key binding features here. And simply now these are the different things like select all, copy. When we will press any of these keys, then this will directly refers to this particular functions out right there which I have created. So now we will open up the menu bar. So I will just pack this in the root config menu bar. And now if someone clicks this main.py file, then it will say that please run the main file, because it is not the main file, it is just a function, or you can say a module for it. So let's see another file. So this is the file menu. So here I have already imported the system here, system module, and here I have created a class with names of some functions like new file, save file. So all these are comes with the functions here, that is self.txt, the text file with some delete. And you can see we have the save as, we have the open file, we have the quit. So basically this will automatically destroy all the windows that are opened at that time, and it will basically refer to init again, same thing. And I have also added some key binding features in this particular function. You can just try this application out and you can figure out what things are going behind it. If you can't learn anything from this, then you probably can comment me down below so that I will create a particular tutorial on that topic of using Tkinter. So now if this will not work, then it will print please run main.py. So let's open up another file. Here is another file, and it will basically the format. So it will change the BG color and things like that. So here I have added some hex code. Now the things to note here, that it will ask you for the color and a thing like that. If you want to bold, then there is no such function to bold it. So you probably want to just get those things, because by we can just here use the wait functions here, wait equals to bold, which will automatically bold our text. Now italic, same thing, you can give here, pass your italic. Now underline, just do the same, and overstroke, and add date. Now date for date, you can just use this time.local time, which will basically give you the total name or your functions, whatever that are. Now here we have the main file, which will basically cover up all the things. If I just minimize this, then you can see here we have all the bindings and thing like that. So this binding will directly refers all these things, all this definition which I have created. And it will, if we don't run this file, then it will open up and pop up so that please run main.py. So this thing works well. So let's open up another file. This is the last file, and here is the class which I have created of help, and I have defined a function here that if anyone just click on that help file, then it will open up and say that created by Pratyush Mishra from Proxlite, and this is the about message here. So I have given a title, and to pack this thing, I have just created a help here, help variable, which directly refers to this functions or this class. And now here we have different like help menu, and we have the thing. So now you can add the cascade to the help menu. So this is the menu basically, and you can just make that menu bar by using this root.config and menu bar function. And if anyone just mistakenly open it, then it will print please run main.py. So let's open this main.py and see what is there. So here is the main.py. So here are basically all the functions that I have created, like root.title, it will give you a title, and here are the geometry and min size, max size. And as you can see here, I have just imported the Tkinter, so .tk, things like that. Now whenever there is thing, I have created a class here, that is file menu main in that particular previous file. So this directly refers to that thing, and here I have ended it by using that root.main loop, which will close it. So these are all the things. And if you want to try this application, then you can go to the description and download it by there. So let's open up the application right on there. So as you can see, when I open up this main file, you will get this window, and when you minimize this, you will get this amazing nice little thing. So Yeah, it looks great. You can just do something like that, and you can just save this file. You can quit, and you have edit functionality, you have the format, you have the help file, all these things. So this is a great editor and a great way to learn Python. So if you want more tutorial like this, then please comment down below. And I think this tutorial was really helpful, and if it was helpful, then consider subscribing and hit the like button below. Goodbye.